guys, it's your boy D-Pad back with another 2K19 video. Guys, here we are with our Pure Shot Creator shooting guard 6'6", 200 pounds. We're here playing some twos with our good old friend Stuart. And man, we were doing some work on twos, man. Doing some work on twos yesterday, man. Stuart, with his post scorer, man, is absolutely deadly. If you guys are checking out the clips at the beginning, man, even though those guys were a little bit smaller than Stuart and were stupid enough to hop on the court, Stuart was making the best of it and absolutely destroying them. And it's so much easier. It's so much easier when you have a big man on the court that can actually be dominant in the paint. I know you guys probably see this the day to day in the park, in the Jordan rec, whatever. Big men that do not use their archetype. And especially on twos, you see the worst of it. You'll have big men that literally will pass the ball out, set a screen, pass the ball out, and it's up to that guard or whoever else to make every last point. And I was actually looking for someone to play with that wasn't gonna put me so much in that position. Not that I'm afraid of being in that position or don't like to be in that position. It just makes the game flow easier. You get easier dubs. It's just easier, man. And, you know, look at people like Batch Plug, and he has Sane and those. I mean, oh my God, man. When you have a big man that is actually putting in work in the paint, it is just unbelievable how easy it is to actually get some W's on the twos. So here we are, man, just playing with Stuart, man. And I'm thinking about making a build or a big man that's like a roundabout like Stuart's build, because it is absolutely dominant in the paint, man. You're gonna see him doing post-up fadeaways, whatever else may be, just to get a bucket, and he's making the best of it, man. He's making the best of it. Absolutely nasty with that build. If you guys know from 18, Stuart was a sharpshooter, so surprisingly enough, you got a sharpshooter, changed it to a big man, and he's doing better than most big mans out there. If you are any type of pure shot creator, anything, a shot creator itself, Mr. Playmaker, whatever the case may be, a sharpshooter, please, by all means, don't end up and play twos and don't be playing with not a big man. It's just stupid. And you shouldn't do that at all, man. Some people are like, oh man, how do we get W's or, you know, on twos and stuff like that? I'm like, dude, get a big man, first of all. There's no reason why you guys are out there with two guards. Now, me and Rels, which is Rels, have done it a couple of times and came out on top more times than losing. You know what I mean? And it's probably because of our chemistry and our defense that makes, you know, it a lot easier. But it's stupid. Do not end up on twos without a big man. And especially find you somebody that's somewhat dominant in the paint, man. It's gonna fix your record. It's gonna make things easier, man. Playing threes on 2K19 is absolutely trash for right now. It is trash right now. I have seen the worst of it on threes. Anybody can make a bucket, anybody can win. It's just absolutely ridiculous. And I have seen the worst records, the worst lineups absolutely win, and it is crazy, man. So I have made a thing to myself, like, dude, no more threes for at least like a month or two. I'm done with it, man. I'm absolutely done with it, because I have lost some games, guys, that is just like, really, man? And then your third does something and it's like, come on, man, when you could have just worried about only you and your big man or something like that on twos. It's just like, it just makes it easier, man. So I am gradually going towards, look at that green. Whoa, we might have to replay that for you guys, but oh my God. I just wanted to make this video, guys, just to update you guys on what I have been doing. I've been playing a lot of twos and grinding my career and playing the hell out of the Jordan rec. Okay, guys, I'm gonna put on the screen now, guys, so you guys that are out there are like, oh my God, what's your dribble pull up? What's your shot? What is this? What is that? Every video, I try my best to put it out there at the end of the video so that you guys know what I'm using, okay, guys? Because day to day, I would change something or buy something new and just to try it out and stuff like that. So why not share it with the rest of you guys out there? Guys, I shall be streaming also later on today. Please be on the lookout for that. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please by all means do that. Turn those notifications on so that you know when I'm live and you know when I upload my new video. If you guys do not follow me on Twitter, please by all means do that at Psycho D-Pad. All links will be in the description below. I appreciate every single last one of you guys, so please leave a like and a comment and let me know that you were here. Okay, it's been your boy D-Pad. I'll see you guys later on for the live stream. Peace and motherfucking hair grease. There he is.